appointment of pastors to parishes and dioceses is one of the most important responsibilities that a bishop has. And I assure you that I take that responsibility in the Diocese of Joliet very seriously. Now, I meet with a board of priests who are elected by their peers, the priest personnel board, and we hash out the possibilities for parish assignments. In the case of the situation here in Kankakee, when a new parish of St. John Paul II was to be established, the choice of a new pastor seemed pretty obvious. There was already somebody who was here, somebody who was already pastor of the three parishes that would be merged, somebody who seemed to have the qualities that were needed to work on bringing people together. I know there's a long way to go, a lot of challenges, but I'm confident that Father Santos Castillo has the gifts to be able to do that. So, my brothers and sisters, it is with confidence and hope that I present to you formally the new pastor, Father Santos Castillo. Peter didn't think this was his own idea. Jesus points out to him that it was the Heavenly Father who gave him these words to say. It is important for the apostles to know who Jesus truly is, because they will be sent forth into the world to do his work. And all but St. John will die as a martyr carrying out that work. It will be important for them to realize that every day, every minute that they carry out their apostolic ministry, it is not theirs. They're not doing this in their own name. They are doing it on behalf of Jesus Christ, who is not just another man, who is not just a wonder worker or an effective preacher, who is not just a kindly neighbor or a gifted member of the community, but is the Son of God, the Savior of the world. You see, that makes all the difference in the way in which they would carry out their ministry, who they are serving, in whose name they are ministering. And what was true for the apostles is true for any of us who are ordained to ministry in the church. It is never in our own name that we minister. It is always representing Jesus Christ, the eternal high priest, the good shepherd. He is the real pastor of the church. Now, most of you are old enough to have known a few priests, and you know two things about us. First of all, we are all not the same. We come in all sorts of sizes and shapes and personalities. And secondly, you know that we are not perfect. You know, if you know us for long enough, what our faults and our shortcomings are. And that, too, is why it's critically important for us as priests and also for you as members of the community of faith to understand that we do not carry out the ministry as our own. That we are not setting ourselves forth as the real shepherd of the church. We do our best, but our best would never be enough. It is not the pastor of a parish who is the center, the touchstone, the source of life for that community. No matter how talented he is, no matter how effective he is, no matter how dedicated he is, it is always our Lord Jesus Christ. Something similar happens, I think, in families, at least in mine. My mother died 2 years ago. And of course, her passing was a great loss. But in these 2 years, I've come to understand that my mother served as the touchstone for our family. We're still a close family. We still care for one another. But my mother's departing from us has changed the dynamics in the family. Our relationship with her defined our relationships with each other. And so her absence now has changed the dynamics in the family. So it is with Christ. It is Christ with whom we have our fundamental relationship of faith. From the pastor down to the smallest child. And it is through Christ, then, that we relate to one another. Most especially, we understand that as we come to the Eucharistic table and share in the body and blood of Christ. It is through him that we become one. So, on this day when I'm pleased and proud to install Father Santos Castillo as pastor of this new parish of St. John Paul II, it's important for all of us to know that someone is asking, who do you say that I am? And that we always know who he is. St. Paul advised the Christian church at Corinth that there are different kinds of spiritual gifts of the same Spirit. There are different forms of service of the same Lord. There are different workings of the same God who produces all of them in everyone. Every parish is blessed with individuals who assist the pastor with their gifts as members of the parish staff. I ask that the members of the staff of St. John Paul II Parish now stand. Father Santos, I encourage you to recognize in these men and women the gifts of the Holy Spirit and allow them to share in your ministry in the spirit of mutual trust, common prayer, and heartfelt concern for each other and the members of this community of faith. Staff and baby seat. And now I ask the members of the parish pastoral council to stand. Father Santos, these men and women represent the larger membership of the parish community of St. John Paul II Parish. It is their charge to give voice to the needs and hopes of the community and to offer wise counsel to you. Humbly lay before them your pastoral concerns and always be attentive to their counsel. Members of the council may be seated. Father Santos, St. Paul, again in writing that first letter of his to the Corinthians, refers to the complexity of the church, likening it to the human body with its many parts. Sitting before you is a portion of St. John Paul II Parish. Here and beyond this particular assembly are men and women, young and old, strong and weak. You come here in the stead of Christ, the Good Shepherd, to teach, to sanctify, and to lead. Always be a wise teacher, a holy priest, and a gentle father for this people, so that you may help to perfect them in Christ, who will strengthen all that you do.
Bishop Conlon, I am grateful to you for entrusting this parish to my care. May the Holy Spirit endow me with the unique gifts required to exercise an effective ministry among his people. May Christ, the eternal high priest, join me ever more closely to him during my time of service here. To the people of St. John Paul II Parish, I pledge to serve you as best I can as father and shepherd. I look forward to working closely with the staff, or to continue working with the staff, pastoral council, finance council, and other leaders of the parish in faith, hope, and love to fulfill the mission Christ has given to his church.
Now, Father Santos, as everyone stands, I ask you to lead us in the profession of faith.
I, Father Santos Tagliato Castillo, with firm faith, believe and profess everything that is contained in the symbol of faith, namely,
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, to their office. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess on baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With firm faith, I believe as well everything contained in God's word, written or handed down in tradition, and proposed by the Church, whether in solemn judgment or in ordinary and universal magisterium as divinely revealed and calling forth faith. I also firmly accept and hold each and everything that is proposed by the Church, definitely revealed regarding teaching of the faith and morals. Moreover, I adhere to religious submission of will and intellect to the teachings which either the Roman Pontiff or the College of Bishops enunciate when they exercise the authentic magisterium, even if they proclaim those teachings in an act that is not definitive. On assuming the office of pastor, I promise that I shall always preserve communion with the Catholic Church, whether in the words that I speak or in the way I act. With great care and fidelity, I shall carry out the responsibility by which I am bound in relation both to the Universal Church and to the particular Church of Joliet, in which I am called to exercise my service according to the requirement of the law. I am carrying out my charge which is committed to me in the name of the Church. I shall preserve the deposit of faith in its entirety, hand it on faithfully, and make it shine forth. As a result, whatsoever teachings are contrary, I shall shun. I shall follow and foster the common discipline of the whole Church, and shall look after the observance of all ecclesiastical laws, especially those which are contained in the Code of Canon Law. With Christian obedience, I shall associate myself with what is expressed by the Holy Shepherds as authentic doctors and teachers of the faith were established by them as the Church's rulers. And I shall faithfully assist the Diocesan Bishop of Joliet so that apostolic activity exercised by the mandate and in the name of the Church is carried out in the communion of the same Church. May God help me in this way, and the Holy Gospels of God, which I touch with my hand.